students, welcome to the biology class of StudyGist. Today we will continue with the chapter health and disease. In this class, the topic which will be discussed, these are about three diseases: jaundice or hepatitis, rabies and AIDS. About three diseases, we'll first discuss about the symptoms of those diseases, what are the prevention and how we can control these three diseases. Okay. But before we start, I want to give you the, I want to remind you about our social media platforms through which you can reach us. Firstly, our YouTube channel, StudyGist Academy. Do subscribe our channel, like our Facebook page, join our Telegram channel. The link is provided here and the name of the channel is StudyGist School 7 to 10. It looks like this. In this channel, each and every updates about the live classes and the study materials will be available. Follow us on Instagram. Join us through WhatsApp community. The number is displayed over the screen. Note the number and join. For more updates and details, do visit our website www.studygist.in. Now in Google Play Store, our free app of StudyGist is available. It looks like this. It's a very user-friendly app, and through this app, the live classes of every subjects are conducted. Apart from the live classes, the recorded classes as well as the study materials and important notes are also available. So download the app and install it now. This is how our YouTube channel looks like. So as I told you earlier, do subscribe our channel, and after subscribing, don't forget to hit the bell icon to get instant notification whenever any new videos will be uploaded in our channel. This is how our Facebook page looks like. So like us on Facebook too for being united with us. So let's start today's discussion. So our first topic of discussion today is about jaundice or hepatitis. It is what? It is a disease. It is a disease of liver. So jaundice or hepatitis is a disease which affects the liver. Since the liver is very, very important organ in our body, so its inflammation or its swelling due to jaundice, it affects the digestion adversely. Liver plays a very important role because we know that liver secretes one juice, that is bile juice, and this bile juice is released in the small intestine and it helps in the digestion of fats, emulsification of fats, right? So if the liver is inflamed, inflammation is found due to the jaundice, then the digestion process will be affected very badly, and it is a viral borne infection. So if you are asked that jaundice is bacterial borne, virus borne or any other microbe borne, so the answer will be viral infection. Okay, the types of hepatitis are hepatitis A, hepatitis B and hepatitis C. Some other hepatitis are also there, like D, E and G. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 types of hepatitis are there. Okay, except for the type B, hepatitis B, which is a DNA virus, all other viruses are the RNA viruses. So if you are asked from all types of hepatitis, which is the DNA virus, the answer will be hepatitis B. This is the DNA virus, and rest all, that means the hepatitis A, C, D, E and G, all are the RNA virus. And how it is spread? It is spread mostly by consumption of contaminated food as well as water with the hepatitis virus. Okay, so in this picture you can see this is a healthy woman, and here due to jaundice, due to hepatitis, a pale appearance is visible. Okay. Now we'll talk about hepatitis A. Hepatitis A, or it is the infection which is caused by RNA containing virus. That means in that virus, RNA is present. It is an acute infection. It is not chronic. Now, what is acute and what is chronic? You know that acute disease is not long lasting, but it is infectious by nature. So it's acute infectious disease of the liver, and it affects mainly the children and the young adults, not the old people. They are not infected by this disease. Transmission of hepatitis A virus, or HAV, it takes place by the fecal oral route. That is, the infection of HAV takes place by ingestion of contaminated food or drinking water, or sometimes drinking contaminated water also. So in this way, hepatitis A can be transmitted. Now, what are the symptoms of it? Firstly, high temperature, headache, extremely headache, then fatigue, bahut weak ho jata hai body, or joints mein bahut zyada pain hota hai. Next is loss of appetite, means you will not feel hungry at all, with a feeling of nausea, and a vomiting feeling will also be there. Appearance of irritating rashes on the body, all over the body, irritating rashes will be found, and the color of the urine will be dark yellow. So dark yellow urine is the indication that the person is suffering from jaundice. And light colored stool after 3 to 10 days of the infection. This is also one symptom through which anyone can understand that person is suffering from jaundice. Now, what are the preventive measures? How we can prevent it? So about the prevention for avoiding the infection of hepatitis A, the following measures must be taken. Firstly, chlorinated water, boiled water, or ozonized water must be taken. So use of chlorinated water, use of boiled water. Firstly, simply we can boil water, maximum germs will be killed. So chlorinated water, boiled water, as well as ozonized water must be used. Proper cleaning of hands after handling bed and vessels of the patients. This is very, very important. And lastly, hepatitis A medicine should be taken to prevent the disease. How we can control it? Firstly, the application of interferon injection. Interferon is the antibiotic. Through injection it is provided. So through injection, interferon injection must be applied on the advice of the doctor, and it can help to control the disease. For an early cure, agar hum log ko bahut jaldi cure hona hai, bahut jaldi recover karna hai isse, so it's essential that a patient of jaundice takes adequate rest. Proper amount of rest is very, very essential. Jaundice patient should take high calorie diet, such as juice of sugar cane, radish with jaggery. These two drinks are very high calorie diet, and it can help very much. It can be very, very useful for the jaundice patient to recover faster. Next, consumption of protein and fat should be limited. It should not be much. Means nuts, all the ghee, butter, these kind of things, all the proteins, that means meat, fish, eggs, these must be controlled, or this must be taken or consumed in limited amount. Next, hepatitis B. Hepatitis B is also known as serum hepatitis or transfusion hepatitis. It is a double-stranded DNA virus. So only hepatitis B is different from the other types of hepatitis. So it's a DNA virus. DNA virus is double-stranded virus. It is the most dangerous and widespread type of
viral hepatitis. It occurs due to the infection of hepatitis B virus, that is HBV, which is a blood-borne DNA virus and very, very dangerous. The infection of HBV is transmitted by infected blood and inoculation. अब इनोक्यूलेशन का क्या मतलब है? इसका मतलब है इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ वैक्सीन इनटू द लिविंग बीइंग टू गिव इम्यूनिटी. एक वैक्सीन को इनकॉर्पोरेट करना, इंट्रोड्यूस करना बॉडी में, फॉर विच पर्पस? फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग इम्यूनिटी टू द बॉडी फ्रॉम मदर्स टू देयर बेबीज एंड बाय सेक्सुअल रूट. ओके, व्हाट आर द मेन सिम्टम्स ऑफ हेपेटाइटिस बी? So hepatitis B, the main symptoms are progressive liver disease, बहुत ज़्यादा liver बहुत ज़्यादा affected हो जाता है, chronic active hepatitis, carcinoma, these are the symptoms. Infection of HBV or hepatitis B virus can be prevented by avoiding risky practices such as free sex must be avoided. Injectable drug abuse and direct as well as indirect contact with blood, with semen or other body fluids of the patient of the hepatitis B, from that there must be a control, there must be in the direct and indirect contact se hamesha dur rehna chahiye taki hepatitis B na ho. Usko rokne ke liye direct or indirect contact with the blood, with the semen or with any other body fluid must be controlled. Hepatitis B vaccine should be taken to prevent the disease as well. Next one is the rabies. The bite of a rabid dog or the mad dog, which is commonly known as mad dog, and some other rabid mammals such as monkeys, cats or rabbits, they may cause rabies. Rabies is the disease which is caused by the bite of rabid dog or mad dog and some other mammals, rabid mammals. They are called rabid mammals, like the monkeys, cats and even the rabbits. It is a very fatal viral disease caused by the rabies virus, or it is also known as Lysa virus, which is present in the saliva of the infected animals. Infected जो animals होते हैं उनकी saliva में वो लोग ये carry करता है, ये virus carry करता है, और ये virus उस bite के वजह से saliva से secrete होके body में enter करता है. The viruses are injected into human blood by the bite of the rabid animal. Disease symptoms are not visible after infection even up to 1 to 3 months. मतलब infection हो जाने के 1 से 3 महीने के बाद भी कभी कभी symptoms जो है वो पता नहीं, symptoms नहीं दिखता है, इसीलिए nobody can understand that that person is suffering from this fatal disease. The long period of incubation makes it possible for a rabies vaccination after a bite to develop immunity and also to prevent the appearance of the disease. Now, what are the symptoms? See, rabies is characterized by severe headache. Firstly, severe, some symptoms are there which are common for all these diseases. So, firstly, headache, high fever, painful contraction of muscles of throat and chest. This is something different from many diseases. Throat and chest region ka jo muscles hota hai, wahan muscle contraction ke time mein bahut zyada पेन होता है, या फिर कंट्रक्शन बहुत ज़्यादा, द इवेंट ऑफ कंट्रक्शन ऑफ द मसल्स इन द थ्रोट एज वेल एज इन द चेस्ट रीजन बिकम्स वेरी मच पेनफुल एंड द पेशेंट फील्स रेस्टलेस, डज एक्सेसिव सैलिवेशन बढ़ जाता है बहुत ज़्यादा एंड हैज अ चोकिंग फीलिंग. हमेशा लगता है कि गला जो है वो एक चोकिंग फीलिंग होता है, चोक किया हुआ मतलब ऐसा फील होता है. And finds difficulty in the intake of even liquid food. Liquid food consume करने में भी problems, मतलब they are not comfortable even in case of consuming the liquid food too. So how we can prevent it? Firstly, by cleaning the wound with carbolic soap and the clean water immediately when the bite is happening, then and there, immediate after the bite, if the proper wash of the wound with carbolic soap and clean water is done, that will be a very important preventive measure. Any antiseptic medicine like Savlon, Dettol, anything that should be applied on the to the wound region which is caused by the bite of the dog. The doctor should be immediately consulted for applying the anti-rabies vaccine to the patient. Whatever proper anti-rabies vaccine should be applied to the patient, the particular patient, that will be told by the doctor, and as proper direction that must be followed. Next, compulsory immunization of stray dogs and the cats should be done, and pet dogs should be vaccinated with anti-rabies vaccine. जो pet dogs होते हैं, जो stray dogs, street dogs होते हैं, उनका हम लोग नहीं कर सकते, लेकिन जो pet dogs होते हैं, उनको vaccine देना बहुत जरूरी है, which must be with anti-rabies vaccine. A rabid animal shows excessive salivation and tries to seek isolation after bite. Such mad animals should be killed. ये mad animals को हम लोग की safety के लिए they must be killed. So how we can, next is how we can control it, about the control. Rabies can be treated with Pasteur's treatment, in which a course of 14 vaccines was given. Currently 5 anti-rabies vaccines are prescribed at an interval of 0, then 3, then 7th, 14th and 30th day of dog bite. Ye interval mein 0 se leke matlab first day, then after 3 days, then after 7 days, then 14 days, then ultimately after 1 month, that's the 30th day. In this interval, these vaccines, anti-rabies vaccines, must be applied, must be given after the dog bite. Our next disease is the AIDS. AIDS stands for Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome. Right? It is a very fatal disease, and the disease of AIDS is caused by a retrovirus. A retrovirus is a RNA virus. That means this virus contains RNA as their genetic material. And it is, this virus is also known as, commonly known as HIV virus, and the full form of HIV is human immunodeficiency virus. So AIDS is the disease which is caused by a retrovirus or the RNA virus, and the name of the virus is HIV, that is human immunodeficiency virus, right? AIDS virus or HIV virus or AIDS causing virus, it attacks the WBCs, that's the white blood cells or the lymphocytes of the human beings, and in this way what they basically do, they weakens the natural immunity system of the human and also the self defense mechanism. जब भी कोई antigen बाहर से attack करता है, हम लोग की body का जो natural immune system है वो बहुत active हो जाता है, और the proper WBCs and lymphocytes they start to work on it, but ये जो cell, इससे जो self डिफेंस मैकेनिज्म नेचुरली बॉडी में बन जाता है, फॉर्मेशन हो जाता है, वो उसको वीक कर देता है. सिंस द एड्स वायरस रिड्यूसेस द नेचुरल इम्यूनिटी ऑफ द ह्यूमन बॉडी, इसीलिए द पेशेंट्स सफरिंग फ्रॉम एड्स बिकम प्रोन टू मेनी अदर इन्फेक्शंस और डिजीजेस. ये नॉर्मल नेचुरल जो इम्यूनिटी है बहुत कम हो जाता है, बहुत वीक हो जाता है बॉडी, इसीलिए जो नेचुरल बहुत कॉमन डिजीजेज हैं उससे, उस टाइम में एड्स में इन्फेक्टेड होने के बाद कॉमन डिजीजेज जो भी है, जिससे कि नॉर्मल कंडीशन में हम लोग की बॉडी बहुत ही अच्छे से फाइट कर सकता है, उस कंडीशन में ये इतना वीक हो जाता है कि जो उतना स्ट्रांग नहीं भी है वो वायरस, पर उस वायरस या उस माइक्रोब से बहुत ही ईजिली अटैक्ट हो जाता है और उसका विक्टिम बन जाता है. In fact, the persons who are suffering from AIDS, they may die from this infection. Death occurs because a patient's body cannot resist the attack of the pathogens of the secondary infection, since the patient's natural defense mechanism gets completely destroyed by the action of AIDS-causing virus. Now, how these are transmitted? AIDS disease gets transmitted among human beings during by many ways. Like this AIDS disease usually spreads through the unprotected sexual contact with one infected person who is carrying AIDS virus, and by sexual contact it may be transmitted. It also spreads through the transfusion of blood contaminated with AIDS virus. Suppose during the transfusion of blood, if from an infected person, if the blood is transfused, if it is transferred, then if the person, the donor person, if he is suffering from AIDS, then by the transfusion of blood, it will be transferred to the healthy person. Okay. It also spreads through the transfusion of blood contaminated with AIDS virus. Suppose the blood which is transfused, not talking about from one person to another person, but from any source of blood from where it is transfused, if that blood is contaminated with AIDS virus or HIV virus, which can cause AIDS, that can also be a reason. The AIDS disease also spreads through the use of infected needles for injections. So if infected needles, that means for during the sharing of infected injection needles, which they are not sterilized properly, once they are used, firstly they must be thrown, and if in that case it has to be used, then it must be sterilized properly. It must be autoclaved or sterilized properly. If it is not done, then they are prone to infection. An AIDS infected mother, this is a very dangerous case where an AIDS infected mother can also transmit the virus to her child during pregnancy or during the birth. So during giving birth, this vertical transmission of AIDS from mother's body to the baby, to the fetus, can also be transmitted. Now, what are the symptoms? Some important symptoms of AIDS are like swollen lymph nodes. Lymph nodes get swollen. Fever, bahut regular fever aate hain. Sweating hoga at night, not always, at night, and tremendous weight loss and sweating during night time. This is one specific symptom through which one can assume that person may be suffering from AIDS. This causes severe damage to the CNS and especially to the brain, and it may lead to the loss of memory, ability to speak, and of clear thinking. That means all kinds of clarity of memorizing, that the memory will be lost, the ability, proper ability, as we are speaking normally with full of clarity, that will be lost, that will be disturbed. The ability of speaking will be disturbed, and clear thinking also will be stunted. Next, about the prevention and control of AIDS. So far, this is a matter of great regret that there is no specific medicine or antibiotic or proper vaccination is discovered. So it is not discovered. So how we can control it, how we can prevent it? We have to take the preventive measures before the occurrence of the disease. Once it is occurred, then there is no way to get rid from it. Okay. So once a person gets AIDS, it is sure that he or she will have to die in a short span of time. It may differ from person to person, but there is a surety that definitely the person is going to die. The people should be educated about AIDS transmission. That this education of AIDS, this proper idea of AIDS transmission must be known, all the people must be aware of it, must be known to the fact. It should not be like that how they are transmitted, what is the fatality of it, the people do not know. The people must have the idea of the transmission of this dangerous disease. Disposable syringes and needles should be used for injection. And next, sexual contact with unknown people must be avoided. Because when this unknown sexual contact is happening with unknown person, we are not aware of their medical history, if they are suffering from it or not. So with unknown person, sexual contact must be avoided. High risk groups should refrain from donating blood, definitely. And next point is very, very important, that the sterilized needles may be provided to the drug addicts. Before receiving the blood for transfusion purpose, one should ensure that it has been screened for HIV. Means, from the blood bank, if the blood of a specific blood group is going to be transfused, then before that process, it must be properly screened, or the proper screening must be completed, must be done before the process. It must be checked, it must be screened that it is having HIV, it is carrying HIV virus in it or not. It must be before transfusion, it must be HIV free. The common razor at the barber shop should not be used at all, which is commonly used. So to avoid that, we have to be very, very careful in this matter. So this is all about today. See you in the next class with few more topics of this chapter. Thank you.